as you can see, it's a little foggier now because I put a plastic bag over the camera because it was starting to rain on the camera. So I just took it was a Ziploc sandwich bag. I just put it over the camera, and I didn't have a rubber band to put on the bottom, which would have held it in place. But anyway, I went for a while, and you'll notice that it flew off, and later on I stopped, got another one, and put it on with a rubber band that helped us. I stopped at Castleton Corners, actually, and installed another plastic bag that lasted for a little while, and then it stopped raining, so I made it home fairly dry. So that's why it's not as clear as normal. And here is part 5 of our ride. We're heading back towards Castleton and Fairhaven. And anyway, here it is. Well, we fixed our flat tire. Now we're on our way home. Thank you. back at Castleton Corners, and the rain is threatening again. So I have stopped, and I want to go in and see if I can get a plastic bag to put over my camera. And it ended up, they don't have plastic bags except for white ones. And so I dug through my stuff and found an old Ziploc bag that had all my money in it and coins and ID. And I took the stuff out and I used that to get us by. And here it is. struggled with the air pump for 15 minutes now, and I finally got some air into my tire. It was getting so soft coming down the hill into Fort or into Whitehall that it was dangerous, and it was almost flat. So I pumped a bunch more air in it, and when I get home, I'm going to use a different pump to see if I can figure out what's wrong. So we're on our way home. We're in Whitehall. Thank you. end of part 5 of our ride, our adventure. We're leaving, well, we've already left. We left Whitehall, and we're headed towards Fort Ann and on our way home. One more video, and we'll be done. Well, before you go, we got some great news for you. The best news in human history. Eternal life is a free gift. Let me quote you some Bible verses. First John chapter 5, verses 11 through 15. And this is the record that God has given to us, eternal life. That means we can't earn it. And this life is in His Son, Jesus. He who has accepted Jesus as his personal Savior has eternal life. And he that has rejected Jesus has eternal death. These things have been written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that you may know that you have eternal life. Sounds pretty simple. Book of Romans gives you the prerequisites. Romans 3:23, all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Romans 6:23, the wages of sin is death. That's eternal death. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. That agrees with everything we've already said. Romans 10:13, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Saved from eternal death and inherit eternal life. I invite you now to repent of your sin, confess your sin, turn to Jesus, accept the free gift of eternal life provided by Jesus, who shed his blood on the cross to pay for the sins of mankind. Accept Jesus and inherit eternal life. And know for sure you have it.